sambar goes very well with the rice, steamed rice. You know, it goes very well with chapati as well. I like to have it with chapati. It tastes really nice. And look at the jackfruit pieces in this. They're like, you know, chunk of pieces of mutton like they are lying here. So it tastes really good. For that matter, why did I add the 2 or 3 drumstick to this? Because the jackfruit, the tender jackfruit and the drumstick, beautiful combination to make sambar. So that is the reason that we always add, just for the heck of it, to get that taste of that drumstick, we just drop in 1 or 2 of them there. I tell you, if you make this once, you will really start liking the sambar. The sambar tastes so good. Hey foodies, hi, I hope you're all doing well. Today I'm going to do Idichakka sambar. Ingredients needed are about 3/4 cup of the toor dal. This is optional, the normal tamarind. If needed, according seeing the sourness for the curry, if needed we'll add, because we have to see how sour the tomato is. Accordingly I will add the tamarind. And I have cut here pieces of the tender jackfruit. That's a baby jackfruit I have cut. I have made small cubes like this and I have kept. Need turmeric powder, salt to taste, oil for frying as well as oil for seasoning. This is about 2 tablespoons of the coriander seed, 1 teaspoon of the chana dal, a big piece of hing, about 1/2 teaspoon fenugreek seed, about 1 cup of grated coconut, few sprigs of the curry leaves, red chili to your taste, and I have 2 tomatoes for the curry and some drumsticks as well. And here I have for the seasoning mustard, broken red chili and some curry leaves. What I will do, I'll pressure cook the dal and the vegetable together and then let's start doing the frying now. I'm adding about 1 tablespoon of the oil. One side I have, on the other stove I have put the jackfruit and the dal for cooking well. First I will add the hing there. This is not hing powder, that's why I am just roasting it in the oil so that they will get grounded very well when I am grinding the masala. Now I'll add the coriander, I'll add the methi and the chana dal here. I'm going to fry this along with the red chili. Just about 2 minutes. Curry leaves as well I added. I've added the coconut now. We'll start roasting this. I've off the flame. I am done with roasting the masala. Let it cool down completely and then I'll make a fine paste of this. You can add water and make it a fine paste, absolutely no problem. To this pan I have cut the tomatoes, I added little bit of turmeric and I dropped in those drumsticks which I had kept. Now I will be adding the dal to it along with the cooked jackfruit here. See how fine I have grounded the masala and I have kept here ready.
Now, as the vegetable is added and the salt, everything I have added to it, and start cooking.
The dal is nicely mixed, and even the vegetables are really getting cooked in the dal. In another 2 minutes, I will add the masala to it now. I have added the entire grounded masala to it. I am giving it a good mix, and I am allowing the sambar nicely boil in this masala for some more times. Now here I want to check one thing, is the salt and the sourness, because I am not sure if the tomatoes will generate enough of sourness. Otherwise I will add a little bit of sourness to this, and I will allow it cook nicely, in fact boil very well. And I need very less of sourness, so I am adding little bit of the tamarind pulp to it. I am adding little bit of the rock salt also. Give it a good mix. On the other side I am going to make the tadka. I will add there about nice 1 tablespoon of the oil. Normal oil I have added, I have not added coconut oil. I have added the mustard and the red chili broken to it, so it's fluttering now. That I will be adding on top of the sambar. The sambar is done, it's boiled very well. I'm going to off the flame now. You can check at this time now for the salt and sourness. If you feel, if you want to add more, you can add now. Mine, I have checked everything and it's fine, so I'm going to off the flame now.